We have all heard it before. Mitochondria are the powerhouse of the cell. But what does this statement really mean? What exactly do mitochondria do? And the most fascinating question, where did these tiny powerhouses come from? Well, buckle up your seatbelts, we're getting down to the level of the cell to dissect one of the most important and oddly fascinating organelles there is. This little guy right here is a mitochondrion, an organelle that lives in your cells. Mitochondria are present in most eukaryotic cells and are important structures that provide energy to the cell through a process called cellular respiration. Before we get to that, let's take a look inside a mitochondrion. They belong to a class of organelles called membrane-bound and are thus enveloped in a membrane. Pretty obvious, isn't it? In fact, there are two separate layers with two very original names: the outer membrane and the inner membrane. The outer membrane is what separates the mitochondria from the cytoplasm and protects the inner components of the organelle. Because it interfaces with the rest of the cellular components, this membrane must have large pores that allow for the free movement of small molecules into and out of the mitochondrion. Between the outer membrane and the inner membrane is the intermembrane space, another exciting and clever name. Then we have the inner membrane, which in contrast to the outer membrane lacks pores and is relatively impermeable, thus forming a barrier between the intermembrane space and the interior, known as the mitochondrial matrix. This inner membrane is folded into the matrix in these wavy-looking structures called cristae. By forming these pleated structures, cristae allow for increased surface area, which acts as free real estate for some very important residents, the enzymes of the electron transport chain. The more surface area, the more space there is for electron transport chain enzymes, which means the more ATP the mitochondria can produce for the cell through oxidative phosphorylation. In short, more wibbly-wobbly folds mean more energy output for the cell. As you might have picked on, the inner membrane is where all the magic happens. And the magic being aerobic respiration, of course. This is the location of ATP synthesis, which begins with the citric acid cycle in the matrix and culminates in oxidative phosphorylation in the inner membrane. The latter further consists of two parts, the electron transport chain and chemoosmosis. The process of chemoosmosis involves the movement of protons across the inner membrane from the matrix to the intermembrane space through an enzyme called ATP synthase, which uses the electrochemical gradient to drive the production of ATP. The ATP generated through this process is then deployed into the cytoplasm to get to work providing energy for crucial processes throughout the cell. So, mitochondria provide energy to the cell and sustain life. How lovely. But they also have a hidden bad side. They can kill the cell through apoptosis. And although it sounds bad, apoptosis is in fact part of the natural cell cycle. Apoptosis begins with the release of electron transport chain enzymes, specifically the protein cytochrome C. Cytochrome C basically hits the eject button in the cell, prompting an apoptotic response by activating cleaving enzymes called caspases. The caspases get to work, and soon enough, the cell is no more. Mitochondria are also important hubs of metabolic activity in the cell. Metabolic processes, including beta oxidation of fatty acids and the metabolism of amino acids, occur in the mitochondrial matrix. A particularly unique aspect of mitochondria is their method of genetic inheritance. Unlike any other organelle in the eukaryotic cell, mitochondria are semi-autonomous. In this case, this autonomy refers to the fact that they have their own system of inheritance, complete with some of their own genes, known as mitochondrial DNA or mtDNA. This mtDNA is inherited independent of the nucleus, a process called cytoplasmic or extranuclear inheritance. Mitochondria replicate through binary fission, passing on their own unique genome that is much smaller than the nuclear genome and is circular in shape, much like genomes we see in bacteria. Suspicious, right? Remember that similarity for later. Although the cell's nuclear genome does encode some of the mitochondrial proteins, the mitochondria's independent genome includes the code for their own unique transcription and translation machinery, including RNA polymerases, DNA replication machinery, and ribosomes. So, where did this odd little organelle come from? And why is it so different from other cellular aspects? This very question has led to the endosymbiotic theory of mitochondrial evolution, which suggests that mitochondria evolved from the cell symbiotic relationship with an independent organism. Confused? Here's the story. Once upon a time, an anaerobic prokaryote, aka the ancestor of modern eukaryotic cells, engulfed an aerobic bacterium, aka the mitochondrial precursor, and established a relationship where both organisms benefited from each other's presence. This is what we call symbiosis, much like Venom and Brock from your favorite web-slinging hero. Eventually, this little organism became a staple of the larger prokaryotic cell, replicating itself inside it and providing energy to the organism it lived in. Pretty cool, right? This would also explain why mitochondria look eerily similar to gram-negative bacteria. Now that you are beginning to thank your parents for these bundles of energy, here is the fun fact. All the mitochondria you have in your body were inherited only from your mother. That's right, your dad gave you diddly squat when it comes to your cellular power plants. This is called maternal inheritance, and it happens because the cytoplasm of the mother's egg gets turned into the cytoplasm of the zygote, meaning you get all her mitochondria, while the sperm provides only nuclear DNA. In this way, mitochondrial inheritance differs from typical Mendelian inheritance, which is where traits are inherited from both parents. So now you know all about the unique attributes of this odd and interesting organelle that is indeed the powerhouse of the cell. Go ahead and put some of that hard-earned mitochondrial ATP to use and click the like button if you learned something from this video. Subscribe for more science content and click here for another video. See you guys in the next one.